These are chapter notes for chapter 5 and chapter 29. So it's not all, it's only part of both of those chapters. This will go in the spiral notebook. Notes go in the spiral notebook. So the first part is about cell membranes. And so the cell membrane part 1 video is probably going to be your best source for this information. Get yourself a little picture of a diagram of phospholipids, and then give yourself some information about the structure of a phospholipid. You need to be able to define amphipathic. You need to be able to talk about saturated versus unsaturated phospholipids. What's the difference? And talk about the role of cholesterol in the cell membrane. The chapter 5 notes are sections 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, 5.4, 5.5. Help you kind of focus on what is important information in these sections. Here's a diagram of a cell membrane. You need to be able to talk about a fluid mosaic model. The mosaic component means that you have a cell membrane that's made up of a phospholipid bilayer and embedded proteins. The fluid part means that these components, the mosaic components of the membrane, can drift. They're not like stuck in one place. They're not permanent in one place. Make sure you can talk about integral versus peripheral proteins. And then be able to talk about the function of the 6 different membrane proteins. So these are membrane proteins, transport proteins, some that are responsible for enzymatic activity, signal transduction, cell-cell regulation, and the other two are intercellular joining and the attachment to the cytoskeleton and extracellular matrix. Then there are membrane carbohydrates, so talk about those. Talk about passive transport and selective permeability. So membrane is selectively permeable. What is the passive transport component of the selective permeability? Selective permeability, there is active transport. Talk about the active transport component. And notice I've got active transport. I put it about half that page. And then be able to talk about bulk transport across the cell membrane, exocytosis, and endocytosis. And there are 3 different terms for endocytosis, or 3 different types. Then for chapter 29, the only thing that you need to do for that, we're going to put a picture. The only thing that we're going to do for chapter 29 is read over 29.2. That should be relatively familiar stuff and stuff that you already have. And chapter 29.5. So those are the only 2 sections. The notes that you need to make sure that you take, make sure you read over both. And the notes you need to take, make sure you know the difference between apoplast and symplast. Turgor pressure, have a general idea of what it is, maybe give an example. Plasmolysis. We'll define it, give an example. What is an aquaporin? What is its role? And transpiration. And then we'll have vocab number 2.